Hi, my name is Greg. I'm a welding instructor here at Worcester Technical High School in Worcester, Mass. We're here to do our second video on our mini angle sander. We're going to go over safety and setup. So when you get the box, the first thing you do when you get your mini angle sander is you pull it out, check it out, inspect it, make sure there's no cracks, scratches, or any kind of weird things going on with it, and then you're going to put it together. It's really easy to put together. You only need a couple of tools at the beginning, and then you don't need any tools. The first thing you're going to need is the arbor. The arbor's right here in the front of the case, the shiny thing. You put the arbor right in, slides right in relatively easy. I like to use my hands to just kind of get it tight so you don't have to spin the wrenches around too many times. So now it's hand tight, so I need to tighten it. So you take the little wrenches that come with it. You have a smaller one and a bigger one. Then you take the smaller one, goes on closer to the grinder. And I like to put them close to each other when you put them on. You can put it far apart, but it's kind of hard to squeeze them. If you put it together close, you just take your hands like this and kind of squeeze down like scissors, and now it's tightened. So now you're ready to put on the arbor head. It's rubber and kind of soft, so if you get near something, it'll bend, which is kind of nice. If you get in like little angled areas, that's kind of nice to have. Screws on relatively easy. There you go. I like to do this as well, hand tight, and then just give it a little extra love just to make sure it's on by hand. There we go, now it's on, I feel pretty good. It's spinning at 25,000 RPMs. And then the heads go on, they have a threaded back. This has the female, this has the male. Slides on relatively easy by hand. There it is, voila, it's on. If you wanna take it off, same process, take it right off. You can switch the wheels, put on the non-woven disc or the sanding disc, which takes off stock. So here we go, the next step is you're gonna put the air chuck in. If you have a system that adds oil, you don't have to worry about this, but if you don't, dip a little oil in here, just pour a little oil in here, and then you can put on your air chuck, and then you're good to go. What I like about these grinders is they're nice and small and with air, which is nice about air. If it's electric, it doesn't shut off when you drop it out of your hands, but air will, which is a little safer, just an added bonus to pneumatic tools as opposed to electric. And because this spins at 25,000 RPMs, you need to wear certain PPE. First thing you're gonna need is eyeglasses. You're also gonna wanna wear a face shield with that as well, because if something comes off and hits you in the face, it's gonna hurt. Secondly, you're gonna need ear protection. The tool itself is loud, and when you're grinding on the steel is loud as well. So you're gonna need ear protection. And as a little tip from a welder, is that earplugs also work for keeping the sparks or any debris out of your ears, because if anybody's ever had a spark in the ear, they know what I'm talking about. I had that happen once and I almost quit welding. You're gonna need to wear gloves, and you're gonna wanna pick gloves that are suitable for what you're doing. So this is a small grinder, not too many sparks, so I don't need big gloves. Plus, I'll have good finger dexterity and I'll be able to use this grinder. Maybe other times you need bigger gloves, but pick the right size gloves for whatever project you're working on. You're gonna also need to have long sleeves. I usually wear a welding jacket, but you could wear a flannel shirt, anything to protect you from this thing if it breaks apart from hitting directly onto your skin. So if you have any safety tips you'd like to share with us, add them below, and don't forget to subscribe.